My dear brothers and sisters, as I said, today's topic is about knowledge. Knowledge of the deen, to search Islamic knowledge. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made it is obligatory upon us. You know very well this hadith of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, talabul ilmi faridatun ala kulli muslim. Seeking the knowledge is compulsory upon every Muslim. And knowledge is two types, knowledge of the dunya, knowledge of the deen, knowledge of this world, how to maintain our life, how to have good income. All these are knowledge, is good as well. If it is not something wrong, there is no objection. And another knowledge is knowledge of the deen, knowledge of the religion, knowledge of Islam. That is compulsory upon every Muslim. And two types of the level of the knowledge, knowledge fardu kifaya, fardu ayn. So the minimum level of the knowledge, which will make you know Allah and His hukum, His order, His command in your life. You know Islam, minimum knowledge of Islam. You know who is your prophet and what he said to you, what he forbidden for you. To know that, that level is fard, ayn, upon every individual. Because once we'll go to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Today we are praying janazah of how many people? 5-6 people. When they will be buried in their grave, may Allah give them Jannat al-Firdaus, all of them. May Allah forgive them. The three questions they will be asked today, immediately when they will be buried. First question is, Man Rabbuka, who is your Lord? Who did you worship? Do you know anything about Allah, who created you? What was His command to you? How much you try to know about Him? Is not this simple answer, yes, I know Allah is my Lord. That's not enough. What is the requirement of knowing that? وَمَا دِينُكَ, and what is your religion? If you answer, let me, I memorize, my religion is Islam. Okay, memorize, I'll be asking, answering this question in the grave. It's not enough. You need to know what Islam is, submission to Allah. What it means, the submission to Allah? To accept anything Allah said for you to do, I'm doing it. And He forbidden me, I'm abstaining from it. That knowledge of Islam, you will be asked. وَمَنْ نَبِيكَ, who is your prophet? The third question will be asked. All of this mayyitin will be asked today when they will be buried. Who is your prophet? He say, I know my prophet is Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Knowing that simple one sentence information is not enough. Did you read about him? Did you take him as your role model? لَقَدْ كَانَ لَكُمْ فِي رَسُولِ اللَّهِ أُسْوَةٌ حَسَنَةٌ. Did you follow him? You implemented all command of him? And abstained from anything he has forbidden and told you not to do? All these we will be asked. How much time we spend to know all these? Many of us here today to pray. Have we prayed all 5 daily prayers? Or Jumu'ah was our regular practice only? We don't care about 5 daily prayers. We are here at least because there is janazah. If not, some of us maybe not will be praying Jumu'ah even. Janazah, there is no way except to come. But some of us don't know how to pray janazah. And that's why people request, oh Imam, can you remind how to pray janazah? Subhanallah. To know that it is farad upon you, not today. How to pray janazah? If you don't know, you're missing the farad knowledge. You'll be stuck in the grave, you'll be not able to answer. Why you did not know how to pray janazah? You forgot. This is not allowed to forget this one. You need to learn, you need to exercise this knowledge. We pray daily prayer, but how we pray? Some of you pray, we don't know properly to do the sujood and ruku. We just pray without knowing. Well, other people do, I copy that. Is that not enough? There is a sunnah, ay Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, sallu kama ra'aytu minni usalli, pray. You have been seeing me, how I pray. You need to exactly follow my prayer. Did he learn it? That is a question is coming to us. So if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given so much importance of knowledge for this ummah, first ayah of this ummah in the Quran. When it is revealed, اقرأ بسم ربك الذي خلق. Read in the name of your Lord who created. So the reading of your Lord, reading His command, reading knowledge of Islam, discovering it is a very command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It is fard upon us, it is obligatory, it is not nafal. Because through that we know Allah, His attributes, his level, His status, and our relationship with Allah. He also said to the Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam to pray to Allah, to supplicate to Allah, to invoke to Allah, أَقُلْ رَبِّ زِدْنِي عِلْمًا. Say, oh my Lord, increase me in knowledge. Not increase my knowledge. This is translation in simple English is not Quranic spirit. Quranic translation is, oh Lord, increase me in knowledge. It's very significant. Because it's not only earning or acquiring knowledge, putting knowledge in my whole practice together, increasing me in knowledge and practice, in spirituality, in relationship with you. That a dua Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala taught Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. If he is making this dua, how many days we are making this dua to Allah? I know some of us, when you give our children to the maktab, evening madrasa, or weekend school, Islamic school, maybe they will be saying, Rabbi zidni alma, Rabbi zidni alma. But us, we don't need, because we are adult. No, we need to ask now, until we die. طلب العلم من المهد إلى اللحد. So dua is an indication that we need to continue to make dua and to make effort that we learn Islamic knowledge. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his biggest ni'mah after iman is the knowledge. He said in hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, مَنْ يُرِدِ اللَّهُ بِهِ خَيْرًا يَفَقِّهُ فِي الدِّينِ. When Allah wishes for someone good, something to give him good, He bestows upon him the understanding of the deen, the knowledge of the deen. If somebody is deprived, made himself deprived from the knowledge of the deen, he has deprived himself from the biggest ni'mah, bounty of Allah. Just coming to learn Islamic knowledge is so rewarded, so rewardful, so honorable, a kind of job you do. مَنْ صَلَكَ طَرِيقًا يَلْتَمِسُ فِيهِ عِلْمًا سَهَلَ اللَّهُ لَهُ بِهِ طَرِيقًا إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ. Okay? Allah makes the way to Jannah, paradise, easy for him who follows a path in search of knowledge. وَإِنَّ الْمَلَائِكَةَ لَتَدَعُوا أَجْنِحَتَهَا لِطَالِبِ الْعِلْمِ رِضًا بِمَا يَصْنَعُ. The angels lower their wings over the seekers of knowledge, being pleased with what he does, to honor you, to respect you. If you are attending an Islamic circle in any masjid, in any place, with this sahiniya intention, good intention, you are so much honored. The angels show their respect to you. وَإِنَّ الْعَالِمَ لَا يَسْتَغْفِرُ لَهُ مَنْ فِي السَّمَوَاتِ وَمَنْ فِي الْأَرْضِ حَتَّى الْحِيطَانُ فِي الْمَاءِ. The inhabitants of the heavens and the earth and even the fish in the depths of the ocean seek forgiveness for the seeker of knowledge or and for the teacher. So that exercising Islamic knowledge, teaching and learning is so much rewarded, is so much honored. If it is other way, he had never have any relationship with Islamic knowledge, then a living in curse. In hadith, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Ad-dunya mal'una, mal'unun ma fiha illa dhikrullah ta'ala wa ma walah wa 'aliman aw muta'alliman." Rasulullah, Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "The world with all that it contains is cursed, except for the remembrance of Allah, that which pleases Allah, and the scholars and the seekers of knowledge." Either you're teaching or you're learning. You have exercise of knowledge by this one of the two way, maybe both way. Then you are saved from the curse. If not, the whole dunya, your name and fame, your position, your honor, your dignity, your wealth, your house, everything is cursed. Absolutely, as Allah said, "Wal asra innal insana lafi khusr." Indeed, the man is in big loss. Except those who have iman, amal salihat, and advising each other for the haq, for the truth, for the deen, and for the patients. Without that, everything will turn against you. You'll realize one day that you lost everything and go empty hand to meet Allah in your grave. So this is the journey of the knowledge everybody of us we need to make. It is so important to have this ni'mah, this bounty in our life. It is the most important asset in our life. Ali radiallahu anhu, he said, Al-ilmu khayru min al-mal. The knowledge of deen is much better than the wealth. Al-ilmu yahrisuka wa anta tahrisu al-mal. The knowledge you acquire of Islamic knowledge, it will guard you, it will save you. But if you only gather the knowledge, you need to guard your, if you only gather the wealth, you need to guard your wealth to protect it. It is opposite. You need to protect your wealth, but the knowledge will protect you. Al-alim hakim wal mal mahkumun alayh. The knowledge is ruler, and the wealth is the ruled one. The knowledge will say, this wealth is halal, this wealth is haram. This amount of zakat you need to pay. So the knowledge is better. Al-malu yanqusuhu an-nafaqa wal-ilmu yasku bin-nafaqa. If you have wealth and you spend, you buy many things, wealth will decrease because of spending decreasing. But if you spend knowledge, spread knowledge, give to the people, what will happen? Yasku, it will increase more. This is the ni'mah Allah has given us, the opportunity. Many circles taking place here, almost every day after Asr we have a circle here. How many of us will bother to come? We have so much business. One thing is this mobile phone, social media, Facebook, WhatsApp, all this we are busy with. The time we don't spend in the search of knowledge. Nowadays, learning knowledge is very easy through even media. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala give us tawfiq, that we spend time to learn knowledge before we go to the grave, before the time come when people will pray janaza for us, will regret, will cry, will scream, but the Muslims will not hear. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala guide us and help us. Barakallahu li wa lakum fil Qur'an al-azim, wa nafa'ani wa iyyakum bima fihi min al-ayati wa al-dhikr al-hakim, wa aqulu qawli hadha wa astaghfirullah li wa lakum wa li sa'ir al-muslimina min kulli dhanbin fastaghfiruhu wa atubu ilayh, innahu huwa al-ghafur rahim. إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدا عبده ورسوله اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين أما بعد عباد الله اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون واعلموا أن أحسن الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدي هدي محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار وعليكم الجماعة فإن أدى الله ما الجماعة أصلوا على بشير النذير إن الله ملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل وسلم وبارك على عبدك ورسولك محمد رضى الله عن الأربعة الخلفاء الراشدين المهديين الذين قضوا بالحق وبه كانوا يعدلون أبي بكر عمر عثمان وعلي وأن سائر أصحاب نبيك محمد أجمعين وعن الذين يتبعونهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وعنا معهم برحمتك ومنك وكرمك وإحسانك رب العالمين ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار اللهم إنا نسألك علما نافعا ورزقا طيبا وعملا متقبلا اللهم آت نفوسنا تقواها وزكها أنت خير من زكاها أنت وليها مولاها اللهم اغفر موتانا واشف مرضانا وارحمنا يا رب العالمين اللهم انصر رحمتك على عبادك المستضعفين في كل مكان اللهم انصرهم بنصرك المبين واحفظهم بحفظك المتين اللهم أهلك أعداءك أعداء الدين الذين يحاربون دينك ويقاتلون أولياءك اللهم خذهم أخذ عزيز مقتدر اللهم أنزل عليهم بأسك الذي لا ترده عن القوم المجرمين عباد الله اتقوا الله واذكروه يذكركم واشكروه يزدكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون وأقم الصلاة